All right, start of day 203. Yeah, about to pack up my tent, but everything else is.
Yeah.
Didn't have the best sleep last. Didn't have the best sleep last night. There's been a slow leak on my pad for the last few weeks, but it usually took like 4 to 5 hours for it to deflate while I was on it. But now it's like 30 minutes. So yeah. And then it got worse during the night too, so yeah. Yep. So I'm all sore, but I still gotta hike. And the problem is it's probably gonna be like 5 or 6 days until I get an Amazon order can reach me. So yeah. Yep. So that's gonna be my life for the next week on a defunct pad. On the ground, so yeah. But yeah, other than that, it's a good morning. Seems like a good day. Yeah, gotta get this hiking done. Maybe 2 nights from now I can go in a motel, which I wasn't planning to do, but actually get some good sleep. But yeah, that's about it. That's the plan. It's just a problem I have to deal with. All right, later. Okay, so continue my downhill and that's what today is mostly going to be. There's one small uphill in the middle. And then I kind of start the uphill into Eureka at the end of the day. That's around 20 miles from here. So depending on how quickly I tackle this, it depends. That's how much of that uphill will get done in the afternoon. So yeah. The major problem today is see if I can get some service. So I can order a new sleeping pad. Because I've already ordered new shoes. So I can pick that up in like a week from now. Even though I kind of need them right now, but that's how it works with Amazon out in the boonies like out here. You need at least a week. So yeah, but I am supposed to connect with the 50 again today. So hopefully they'll have service around there. Who knows? Might have to wait till tomorrow. So. If that happens, I'll have to slow myself down. But I don't know exactly when. But I'll get today done as fast as possible. Yeah, because the other thing is, last night I kind of recalculated. I actually went through everything, see how many miles I actually do have left, and I have about only 712 miles from where I was last night, not the 760 or so I thought I had, so that's good news. That's like 2 days or a day and a half of a hiking I thought I would have to do that I don't have to do. So yeah. And that's not counting a shortcut I'm planning to take around Lake Tahoe. So yeah. So I think overall I'm less than 700 miles left of this hike. So that's good. And it seems like because of that, my October 10th deadline is definitely going to be met. And so now it's all about trying to end as early in October as possible. So. Right. As I keep on walking down, today should be an easier day, but still going to try to do a lot of miles. All right, later. All right, so after making a wrong turn, or keep on going straight when it's supposed to be going turn, walking an extra half mile back, I've made it to a very important spot. Somewhere that epitomizes what's out here. I like this sign. Nowhere, Nevada. Yeah. Seems like an abandoned homestead around here. So, but no one has maintained for a while, except for maybe the road. But yeah. Nowhere, Nevada. That's where I'm at. All right, later. All right, made to the water source. It's here, it's flowing well. And yeah, perfect really. I'm gonna fill up completely here because the next reliable water source that doesn't have any question about it is actually in Eureka itself. And that's like 35 miles from here, 34 miles from here. So, yeah, that means filling up completely. It's not that big of a deal. I've done more, but yeah. Means I have to carry a lot out of here, which is the only downside, but yeah. Here's more of the water source, and there's some horses out there. Might even be Mustangs. Pretty cool. I don't know if they're wild or not, but they're taking advantage of the water, that's for sure. Later. All right, so I'm in another big desolate valley. Not as big as some of the other ones I've seen. Decent size. I'm going straight ahead. It's a nice little hill I have to go over. Like 500 feet over 4 miles or so. Not hard at all. That'd be like the first real climb of the day. Gone about 10 miles downhill so far. Well, I will before I start that hike, that uphill. So, yeah. Not bad at all. And I don't have another uphill until the end of the day. It's just a matter of getting the miles done. My pack is a little bit heavy right now because of all the water I'm carrying, but I do have just enough food to get to Eureka, so need some light on that. And as the day goes on, the pack should get lighter and lighter. That's how it works, right? And yeah, it's still, even though it's in a lot of direct sunlight, it's not that hot. It's like mid 80s. That's where it's supposed to max out at today. Or close to it, so. Again, not complaining at all. Yeah. Yeah, every day into September, it's like today's like the 3rd, I think, right? Yeah, it means less and less chance of a late summer heat wave. So, yeah. I've seen a lot of evidence of horses around here, as in like, horse leavings, so. But I haven't, I'm pretty fresh too. I saw those couple of those Mustangs, and that's about it, though. As I keep on moving forward. I'll take another video at the top of this epic hill. Okay, near the top of this climb, wasn't much of one. Was decently long,
That's okay. And it's actually kind of sprinkling on me right now, which I don't mind. Keeps things cool. Yeah. So you get like 1 or 2 minutes of rain. And that's the big storm here in Nevada. So yeah. I keep on moving along. All right, later. All right, new valley, new view. That's nice. I'm actually about to hit the 50 again. And I do follow that pretty much all the way to Eureka. You know, part of that is on like a dirt road next to it, but. And it's mostly uphill on that, so. That should be fun. But I need to get there first. I think I got like 5 to 6 miles more before the before the uphill starts again. So yeah. It's only like 3:40, so I should. My goal is to get within like 10 miles of Eureka. I can get there nice and early tomorrow. Not worry about a post office being closed before I get there or anything like that. And I'm debating whether to get a motel room there. I probably will because last night I wasn't able to sleep that much. Tonight I won't be able to either. Well, he's not well because of my non-working pad. So yeah. That'll be a good excuse to spend money on a hotel room. So yeah. And I can start bright and early the next morning. Yeah. I think that's what I'll do. The debt mounts, right?
Alright, later.
Alright, this is the reason why I filled up the last spot. Completely dry now, the gas generated water trough. Maybe that there's some way to access that, but not sure. I don't want to mess with anybody's stuff. But that's why I filled up completely at the last one. As I have to walk towards the 50 now. Yeah, I got about, I want to say, 18 or so miles to Eureka and water. On the next water, I'm not carrying my back though. And yeah, so I got plenty. But there, it is a 32 miles water stretch, a water carry from the last water tank to Eureka. Just anyone who comes after me, be prepared. That's actually the road's over there. As I keep on going. Okay, made it back to the 50. Yeah. Nice long road. I don't know if you can tell from over there. It starts going uphill in a bit. Not yet. And I think I'm on this road until I get to Eureka, I think. Yeah. Or road paralleling it. So yeah. Back to civilization. Alright, 15 miles to Eureka. Think about 13 or 12 of that is uphill, probably 13. So yeah. Won't be able to do it all tonight, but try to get as much of it done as possible. Yeah. Something about
4 miles from here. You know, it's supposed to be a campsite, so that'd be nice. Somewhere I can actually camp alongside the 50. So yeah, that'll be interesting. So I'll probably be walking into the night to get there, all dusk, definitely, but yeah. And that'll be around 27, 28 miles today, so yeah, good day. Yeah, as the sun almost goes down over that mountain, right there. All right, end of day 203. My hair's all messed up. Yeah, I did end up doing around maybe 27 miles, 26. Yeah, so not as much as I. It's starting to get dark. The 50's right over there on the other side. There's an old highway right here. It's right along the side. That's where I'm going to. I'll be camping in this gully because there's wind. Maybe there'll be a little more cover there. And I don't think it's going to rain. It's not that much. Yeah, all the rainstorms have already passed me. Say rainstorm, it's more like it's just sprinkling. I was rained on for about 3 minutes, pretty heavily. That's probably the extent of it. So yeah, that's precipitation in the Nevada desert. Yeah. So tomorrow I'm about 11 and a half miles away from Eureka, and yeah, I think I'll take advantage of all the motels there. There's a cheap one for $60 that I'll see. Yeah, I'll try to get into it because I have to get there and do laundry probably at a campground nearby and do the bed because, yeah, tonight's going to be annoying with the leaking pad, the slow leak pad I have. I'll try to make it work. All right, I'm gonna set up and eat. All right, see you guys tomorrow.